it's Toya Wilcox here, and you're watching the wonderful Electric Umbrella TV. Yeah!
You are now watching Electric Umbrella TV.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Electric Umbrella TV as we go, as we always do, in a one, a two, a one, two, three, na 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 na. Electric Umbrella! Very good, everyone. You're going to sing after me from all your homes and all your living rooms. Here we go. I saw it in my dreams.
I saw it in my dreams.
Those magical scenes.
Magical scenes.
Amazing, amazing. Electric fun with lots of energy. Yes, everybody. So colourfully. That's that one. Whoop! Fantastic, fantastic. A fan dabby dozy. All together now. Come on, Chris, get your drink out. Oh, one, two, three. Na 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 na. No, 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 electric umbrella. Okay. So, Gavin, our wonderful co-host and co-everything, is going to spotlight me and our wonderful co-presenters for the evening. They are, in no particular order, the one and only Jamie 3D1 JW Selector! And of course, our second co-presenter for the evening is the one and only Emily Mayer with the lovely hair. Hello, you guys. How are you doing? It is lovely to see you, Emily. How are you doing? Very good to see you. Now, Emily, I'm going to start with you. I saw it in my dreams. Jamie, those magical scenes.
Those magical scenes.
Amazing, amazing.
Amazing, amazing.
Jamie, electric fun.
Electric fun.
That's how you do it. Emily, maybe, you know, like with some signs as well. With lots of energy.
With lots of energy.
Jamie, so colourfully. Fantastic, fantastic.
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 And then both of you. Fan Dabby Dozy. Yes, everybody, fan dabby dozy. I like the I like a little dab. It goes a long, long way. It goes, ah, arms in the air, you two. Here we go. Na 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 na. Electric umbrella. La 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 na 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 na. Electric umbrella. Okay. Now, Emily, we are going to introduce our guest for this evening. Are you excited about our guest this evening?
I'm really excited, yeah.
It's going to be really good. Jamie, how are you feeling?
Yes, yeah.
Yes, cool, you're right, it's cool. Jamie, you're not going to have some sort of, like, crazy meltdown with that flesh flashing around your eyes, are you?
No, just having this excuse, Matt.
I feel like anything could happen. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give him a round of applause. His name is Tabby Callaghan, and he is all the way here over from Ireland. But before anything happens, Tabby, we're going to do this with you. Ready? I saw it in my dreams.
I saw it in my dreams.
Those magical scenes.
Those magical scenes.
Amazing, amazing.
Amazing, amazing.
Electric fun.
Electric fun.
Oh, I like that. That's a good way of doing it. Hey, Jamie, do you want to lead the next bit? You know, the next bit goes with lots of energy. Do you want to leave that?
Yeah,
right, you sing it, and then Tabby, you got to sing it however he sings it. Ready, okay. Jamie? With lots of energy. Good. Emily. Now, Emily. So colourfully.
So colourfully.
You've got to do it with the sign, Tabby. It goes like that.
Colourfully.
Yeah, I like that. My bit, it goes, fantastic, fantastic.
Fantastic.
Yeah, Tabby.
Fantastic, fantastic.
Now, I assume you brought your thumbs with you, Tabby. You got your thumbs with you?
I got my thumbs, man.
Great. Now, Jamie's version is to do a dab at the same time. So yeah. You've got to go, I don't know why, yeah, but it goes like this. It goes, Fan Dabby Dozy! Ladies and gentlemen, let's give him a round of applause as we go. Oh, last time, arms in the air, you three. Here we go. All together. Electric umbrella. Na 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 na. And we're all gonna sing. Alrighty, everybody, give yourself a huge round of applause. Well done. My goodness me, you'd have thought that after 143 of these shows, I would not be completely exhausted after the first bit. But I'm always knackered. So welcome to Electric Umbrella TV. My name is Tom. That is my name, if you didn't know that. Joining me today, we have the one and only Jamie as well. So we're going to add Jamie. Jamie, how are you doing? You feeling good?
Yeah, man. Been punked as ever.
You feeling punked as...
My name is 3D1JW.
Yeah. 3D1JW Selector. That's not your postcode, is it?
Well, basically, that's my to be like cybernetic stuff. Great. It's like, I'm like DJing like with all the music that I play on Spotify. Like.
Okay, well, look, listen, we've got Tabby here with us as well, and we've got Emily. Tabby, welcome to Electric Umbrella TV.
Great to be here.
In fact, I think what you actually need is one of these. Tabby, do you remember rounds of applause and things like that we used to get when we used to do gigs and things?
Yeah, oh, yeah. Gosh, I think I'd have a heart attack now if I heard that.
It feels like a long time ago, all of that stuff, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah, it feels like another world.
Yeah, another world. It is another world. Now, tell me, Tabby, welcome to Electric Umbrella TV for a start. I know that I talked to you very early on in lockdown and said, we're going to do this thing. And then we never kind of got it together. I'm so pleased that you're here. How are you feeling? Are you excited?
I'm super duper. It's great to be here. I love the format. I love the whole vibe, the whole buzz, but it's super duper. I'm chuffed to be here. It's great.
We're really pleased.
It's nice to meet everybody here as well. Hello, everybody, at once.
Yeah. Hey, Tabby, what's really important is if you can see at the top right of your screen, you've got a thing that says view.
Yeah.
And if you put it on gallery view, you'll see everybody waving at you, and they are waving at you. You can see them. You can see Emily. You can see Gavin. You can see Billy. You can see Dan.
See everybody.
You can see Rachel. You can see, who else can you see? You can see Jodie, you can see Heidi,
Debbie,
and you can see Joseph.
Billy, Summer, Chris, the drummer.
I'm going to unmute everybody. We're all going to say, hello, Tabby!
Hello, Tabby!
And then I mute everybody again, and life becomes quiet again. Tabby, this is the way we've been working for so long here. Have you done much online stuff, Tabby? Have you done many concerts or anything like that?
Over the lockdown? Yeah, I've done a few things, but I would be nowhere near as technical as you, Tom. You seem to be like, listen, you're like the BBC and I'm like, I don't know, some little like terrible TV station.
No,
so
never.
You're like super pro, and I haven't a clue what I'm doing. You helped me with everything here today, so
you're all
thank you.
Good. You're all good, and it's really great to have you here. First things first, let's go to Emily. Emily, let's ask Tabby a question, and then what we'll do is we'll ask him to sing us a song because that's what we're here for. Jamie,
yeah.
Can I ask a question first? And I'm going to ask Jamie, what are you doing?
I'm just getting my son as well.
Oh, what is that?
Haven't seen Power Rangers Beast Morphus.
Oh, it's a Power Rangers Beast Morphus. Okay.
I knew that.
What are you going to do with it?
Well, basically, what a Morphus does in Power Rangers, it changes you into a superhero suit. And that's like the way it's mentioned in Power Rangers.
We're with you, Jamie. We're with you. And I'm sure Tabby has got one of those.
I have seen one before.
Cool. Hey, Emily, have you got a quick question? And then we'll come straight.
Yeah. Do you write your own songs?
Great question.
Yes, I do. And I'm at the moment, I'm working on a whole load of new songs. Yeah, so I do write my own songs, Emily. Yeah.
Have you been writing much in lockdown?
Yeah, I've been experimenting, and I'm actually working on a lot of new stuff now. It's not ready yet, but it's... it's a different direction for me, Tom. You know, it's kind of Irish type of stuff. And
well, I follow you on Facebook, and I think everybody here should follow young Tabby, because there was this beautiful song that you were playing with your cousin on accordion.
Oh, it's my goddaughter.
Ah, it was fantastic.
Yeah,
I'm trying
she's
to get
great.
Out and play it later. So it's really
yeah,
really...
she's great. That was just off the cuff. You know, it was just. She called one day and we said, you know what, let's do it. And she was so shy, you know, you could see her. She was like, you know,
it's really
she was great though.
It's really worth watching. Hey, yeah. Tabby, before we go any further, this is a music show. We're all about music. Music is the thing that brings us together. You're going to sing us a bunch of songs today. I mean, we sprung this on you a little bit, but what do you fancy singing? What are you feeling like singing?
Oh, gosh. I don't know. I could maybe do maybe something that would suit an acoustic guitar.
Well, look,
I do that one. I like that.
I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll give you a round of applause because that matters, right?
Yeah.
And we'll introduce you properly and we'll say thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give him one of these rounds of applause. Remember how to give those. You have to get your hands right up close to the screen, everybody. And it's really important. And we'll introduce the one, the only, Tabby Callaghan here on EUTV.
Thanks. Am I okay to go? Darkness, guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I sure know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, my life just might pass me by, and that's fine with me. Here we are. So wake me up when it's all over, when I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I've been finding myself. I didn't know that I was lost. I try carrying the but I've only got two hands. Hope someday I get to travel the world, but I ain't got any plans. Wish that I could stay forever this young, not afraid to close my eyes. Life's a game and for everyone, and love is the prize. Sing with me. So wake me up when it's all over, when I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I've been finding myself. I didn't know that I was lost. So wake me up when it's all over, when I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time
ladies and gentlemen. Let's give him a massive round of applause. Get your hands up close to that screen, Gavin. Come on, let's show him how it's done.
Is that okay? Could you hear us?
Woo-hoo! Hey, it sounded great. Really, really good.
I was okay. All right. Happy days, Tom.
Loads of really brilliant responses coming in. I'm getting lots and lots of messages saying how good it is and how brilliant it is. I'm going to ask my great friend, Charlie, who is my glasses twin. Hey, Charlie.
Hi.
What did you think of Tabby?
Hi, Tabby.
Hi, Charlie. How you doing?
Well, super swell to see ya.
Yeah, likewise. Super swell to see you too.
Look, I've been modelling myself on Charlie for months now. And
I can see that.
You're calling your glass twin, hey?
I know. I've got some new
glasses. Oh, my God.
Just because I wanted to be like you, Charlie. Hey, Charlie, are you having a good day?
Oh, boy, am I having a good day or what?
Okay, mate. Well, look.
Nice to see you, Tabby.
Nice to see you too, Charlie. Nice to meet you.
We'll see you in a little bit, Charlie. Really great, Tabby. And thank you for singing for us. It really,
No problem.
This is the music has been the thing that's kept us all together, hasn't it, Emily, over this period?
Yeah, definitely. We're a good team.
It is a good team. Tabby, tell me, like, one thing that has been really important to us in this time has been making new friends. Like, we didn't realise that actually you could make, like, new friends and all of that through this crazy time. Has that been something that you have managed to do? Have you met anyone new in this time, or are you just kind of...
Yeah, actually, now that you mention it, Tom, I have actually made a whole load of new friends. People that I wouldn't normally, I suppose our social circles wouldn't normally combine just because of the work we do. And I found that over the lockdown, because I've been trying all these different things, for instance, I got into growing vegetables over the lockdown. I'd never done anything like that. So because of that, then I was trying to grow a veg at home in my garden, and I got chatting a load of people through that. And I met people who do all that kind of stuff who I never would normally talk, meet.
Yeah.
So it's been lots of interesting little things like that, which has been really cool, actually.
So tell me, like, what vegetables have gone well?
Tell you all the ones that haven't.
Okay. Well, look, Jamie, have you ever grown vegetables?
I do from the allotment with my mum and dad, yeah.
Do you go, when you go to the allotment, do you wear those glasses?
Well, basically, I wear these glasses.
Oh, those glasses. All right, fine. Yeah. That's good. They're your allotment glasses, and these are your party glasses. Is that right?
Well, technically, I use them when I go outside with the sun, because my eyes are not sensitive to the sun.
Your eyes are sensitive because they've got these wild, mad flashing things going on.
Well, no, because I have the... Well, I use these because...
Yeah.
They're so famous in Avengers.
Yeah.
Because these were called... These glasses in the film, in Avengers, were called Edith glasses.
Oh.
Because the Iron Man made... The interface that goes with it, it's called...
I know the ones you mean.
It's called Edith.
Yep.
The interface called Edith, and from No Way Home.
Yeah, I know the one.
Yeah,
Tabby, are you a superhero fan? Do you like superheroes? Do you watch a bit?
Oh, I do, yeah. I really like it, chat.
Did you watch loads of the movies over lockdown? I watched nearly all the Avengers movies over lockdown.
Yeah, of course, yeah. I've watched all of them, yeah.
Good.
I have to say I am a superhero buff. Like, I love all that stuff.
Good. Well, that is good to know, because you're in good company here. Listen, a couple of things that are going to come up. We're going to play you some songs. We're going to introduce you to a bunch of our friends. Jamie is going to do a rap, I think. Jamie, is that right? We're going to do some rapping. Are you into rap? Do you rap?
Who, me?
Yeah.
I rap presents. That's about it. But presents. I love rap.
All right. We'll see what happens. Yeah, we're going to take some questions straight away. Now, I'm going to go to my friend Amy, who is here as a helper on EUTV today. How are you doing, Amy?
Fine, thank you.
First of all, some geography. I was going to do geography because, Tabby, where are you in the world?
I live in Sligo, which is in the northwest of Ireland.
Ah, in the northwest of Ireland. Now, that is very interesting.
The next stop from where I live is America.
Right. Well, I'm going to introduce you to, we've got another amazing friend here who happens to be from the Emerald Isle as well. This is Sinead Quinn, everybody. Let's give Sinead Quinn a round.
Hi. How's everyone feeling?
Yeah, good.
Oh, look, Jerry's here as well. Morning.
Hi, Jerry.
Jerry, say hello. Jerry should be in his bed, but he's here.
Hi, Jerry.
Jerry, go to bed. Bedtime.
I forgot to bring him up a drink. Go on, you know what? Your cup's in there in the kitchen. Go and get it and go up. I'll be up in the room.
Hey, Amy and Sinead here, and they would like to ask you a question, Tabby. So we're going to go to Amy first. Amy, what would you like to ask?
So, who was your favourite judge on X Factor?
Great question.
All right, that's a great question. Well, obviously, it would have been Sharon, obviously. Yeah. Because I was with Sharon,
yeah.
But I knew Louis Walsh as well before that, and so Louis was kind of like, Louis's kind of funny too, like. But I probably have to say, like, I know it sounds obvious, but I would have to say Sharon. I would say, if I'm being honest, yeah.
And then, can I ask you if you'd do a song for me, "Sweet Child of Mine"? I love that song.
Oh wow, you like that one, do you? Well, you know what? I could try it. I was gigging all weekend, so my voice is a bit hoarse.
Okay.
But I give it a try for you, no problem. Do you want me to do that now, Tom, or will I wait?
We'll do it in a bit.
Okay. Yeah, I'll give it a try for you, Amy, though. I promise you.
All right, we're going to come over to another one of our absolutely wonderful members and friends. This is Sinead. Hello, Sinead.
Hi, guys. Hi, Tabby.
Hi, Sinead. How are you doing?
I'm from Fermanagh, like near Enniskillen.
Ashley, you're only up the road from me.
Only up the road, but I was saying to Tom about the whole reality TV thing, because I did the same thing in 2002.
Yeah, all right.
A show called Fame Academy.
I remember Fame Academy, yeah.
Back then, and I was saying, like, isn't it mad? I was just doing a bit of Wikipedia. Well, I was doing a bit of Wikipedia the other day as well, but I was just saying, you were on in 2004, weren't you?
That's right, yeah, that's correct.
Yeah, it was 2002 for me. Isn't it mad how still sometimes you'll be somewhere doing something, and somebody go, oh, were you on that? You were on the TV show. And then you say, what, Crime Watch UK? Yes.
Yeah. I've actually used that line a few times.
Oh, I love that line. But I just wanted to say to you, what has been the hardest thing? Being so up there, for me anyway, being so up there in a television show, even though it was 20 years ago next year for me and, you know, 18 years for you or whatever. The hard thing that I found is people saying, what are you doing with yourself now? It's like, well, I'm still a musician because I was a musician before and stuff like that. What have you found really weird over all of these years? Like, what has been really sort of difficult? And also, another thing was, you're up there and you're doing amazing and people are like they put Sinead on the town clock in my hometown. I came down the town in a limo and let off fireworks at the top of that town clock. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
it's like, I'm doing a gig in O'Neill's last night in Wardour Street, you know,
for really terrible
money. And it's like, what did you find hard, like, from that transition?
Well, everything you're saying there, I can relate to directly. Obviously, you know, I know that feeling of, like, you know, one day it feels like you have the whole world in the palm of your hand and you're at the top of the pinnacle, so to speak, and everybody takes your phone calls and your dad, you've got so much heat on you and you think, oh, you know, we've got this thing in the pipeline and this guy from Interplanetary Records is flying from Mars to sign a deal with me, and you have all these big ridiculous ideas in your mind of all this stuff that's going on. And of course, you know, of course, the real world, because obviously that's reality TV. It's not based on reality. That's the irony of it, actually, is that
it's not really based on music. It's based actually on, it's like a factory.
And well, the thing is,
I don't know about you, I don't feel bitter about it. I feel like it was a great opportunity and I did some things that I'd never get to do.
Sure.
But it is hard to kind of transition from that to that, isn't it?
Oh, it is, yeah. It's like, I think, you know, look, I too have had the dark night of the soul afterward, you know. Now, I was lucky in a lot of senses because I got to do a lot of stuff after it, which kind of more permeated from, like, just my own hard work as well, and, you know. But at the same time, I totally relate to what you're saying. And it's funny because on Saturday night there, I was playing with a band, and that song, that Take That song, you know, Never Forget.
Yes.
And that there, to me, probably describes the whole thing the best you could actually when you actually listen to the words. Because actually, you know, even though I've lived it, I've lived that experience, that reality. When I was listening to it the other night, I was thinking, gosh, that's exactly what it is.
Well, the other thing about yourself and myself is we were musicians long before we went on a television show, and that was just a boost, especially coming from Ireland. It's very hard to make connections. I know you say you knew Louis Walsh and stuff like that, but it's hard to make those connections to kind of get out there and stuff like that there. But really good. But I'll tell you what, Electric Umbrella has been brilliant for me as well. As well as doing gigs, doing Electric Umbrella has just...
Are you back gigging now?
Oh, I'm doing loads of gigs, but I work heavily. I'm a session leader and everything with Electric Umbrella, and it's just joyous. I love all these guys. They are amazing. Every one of them. Everyone give a wave.
Yeah, it's so good.
Everyone's amazing. But I just wanted to come on and say that because I understand exactly how you feel.
And I understand, and same with you. I understand exactly as well with Sinead. I know exactly what you're talking about. I know what it is. I have eaten from that pot. You know what I mean? Yeah. I understand how it feels, what it is. And I know what it is as well with the endless expectations of what's happening now, anything in the pipeline.
I know.
I even remember that there was a period for a long time where I would just come up with nonsense.
I know. And my daddy even said to me, you know, the proud Irish, he's like, if that's smart aleck ass, she'd just say you're doing that. And then it makes you feel worse then.
Yeah,
like,
it does.
Oh my God, is my daddy, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But also, the thing is, the one thing that I think's really gorgeous that I've came to a place where I'm just like, what I'm doing is enough, because I'm working as a musician. That's what I always wanted to do. Everything I did was like fabulous, and I got to do some really cool things. But here we are, still working.
Well, you're living a real life too, you know. I mean, I'm sure you understand that the kind of fame world is, it is 99.9% an illusion.
It is.
And also as well, a lot of the people that are famous are not only under that illusion, but also under that delusion, you know.
Yeah.
Because, you know, like, you find with the whole fame thing, like, that once you get into it, like, you'll never be famous enough. You'll never be successful enough.
No.
You know, there is always that thing. And I think that, like, the greatest thing for me was learning that there is a difference between pursuing happiness and actually pursuing being content, because there is a difference.
Well,
you know?
I was gonna bring a few people in on this, because, you know, when we talk about happiness and we talk about music, you know, like, I was gonna talk to Chloe, right, for example, and Sinead and I know Chloe very well. Chloe, I know that, like, you've been telling me on the chat here that you're not having a great day, and what do you normally do, Chloe, when you're feeling a bit down, and, you know, what is it that you do? Because music helps me.
I don't know really much, because basically Tom, the person who tears me up all the time, has basically is talking to me tomorrow morning.
Right. Is that someone at school?
Yeah, but basically Tom, what he does is basically what I do when I'm upset is I have like a traffic light system, and I'm like, talk to people when I'm upset, and I do that anyway.
Well, Chloe, you know, and I think Tabby will agree, you know, talking to people and music, like, for me, definitely, and I know it's the same for Sinead, you know, music is the key to our happiness sometimes. Tabby, would you say that's true? Has the music got you through some hard times?
Oh, absolutely, yeah. Because music has a way of expressing things that sometimes, you know, talking doesn't. You know, sometimes you can hear a song and it captures how you feel. And you mightn't be able to put that into words, but sometimes the music can do that. So it's a great way of kind of, you know, just kind of resonating with what it is you feel. And it helps to, you know, to kind of help you to get that up out of your system, I find. And also as well, not just the music, but when you like music with friends who like the same music as you, suddenly you've got...
Yeah,
connection with people, and that's really important.
Well, let's just talk about that for a moment, if you don't mind, because we would like to play you a song of ours.
Great.
And I'm gonna ask Emily to come on, because we were talking with Emily earlier about which song of Electric Umbrellas do you think we should play to Tabby here? Because, you know, I don't think Tabby's seen any of our stuff. So, like, we made an album in lockdown. Full album. Do you know what? I haven't got a copy here. I've got 100 copies up in the... This is our first album. We've got our second album, which is called Sunflower Avenue. Now, there's a bunch of good stuff on it, Em, but what one are we going to play for Tabby now that we can all enjoy and remember what we were saying about, like, how music can make you feel good?
Definitely. Music.
Yeah, go. Sorry, what were you going to say, Em?
I was going to say music is good. Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. What song shall we play for him, do you reckon?
Sunflower Avenue.
So you're going to play the song Sunflower Avenue. So this is the lead song, Tabby. This was written during lockdown on Zoom, recorded completely remotely. None of us were in the same room when any of this was recorded. And I'm going to just play this for a little bit of it for you now. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the song called Sunflower Avenue.
I heard there was a place where stars shine, bright as the sun in daytime, a place that I could call my home. Send me a map to where I wanna spend my one life, in a place that I can grow, where flowers all have special powers and they want us to find.
Ourselves a huge round of applause, because we're I tell you, Tabby, like, making that record was something else. What did you make of that?
I can't believe you managed you did that over Zoom.
Yeah, all of it.
That's unbelievable.
All the recording, every single person.
I can't
person
believe that, Tom. That actually sounds great. And I love the message of the song as well. It's great.
Oh, well, thank you so much. Emily was obviously in that video. Everybody here was involved. Emily, what's your memories of making this record? I mean, it was actually this time last year that we were actually recording everything down the Zoom. Do you remember? I would ring you up and say, hey, can you do this line? And I'll just record it straight into my Zoom.
Yeah.
What's your memory of it?
Just amazing. And just as I said before, I never actually thought I'd be in the video. And it was an amazing opportunity.
We've also got another of the celebrity guests on that on that song. This is the one and only Farah, all the way over from Norwich. How are you doing, Farah?
I am mind blown about everything right now. I'm mind blown. Boof.
Why are you mind blown?
Because next week, Tom.
Oh, well, okay. Well, that's something else.
And my question.
Okay, let's get on with that.
My question is, when did you start music and who inspired you to do music?
Great question.
Is that for me? Is that for me, that question?
Yes, it was.
All right, okay. Well, first of all, nice to meet you, Farah.
Very I nice like your accent, by the way, too.
I like yours, too. So when did I start music? Well, I... My mum has always been a singer, right? But not a professional singer. She just used to sing around the house, like with a hairbrush, or and then you know she would if we were like out in a place where there was music, my mum would get up and sing with a band, and then so when I was a kid, then she would make me go up and sing with the bands. So I was only like 7 or 8, and I would be up playing with fully grown adults, and that's kind of where it started with me. And then I had an uncle who played a bit of guitar, and so he took me to I went to London to my aunt's house in Wood Green, and we spent a month there, and he was showing me some chords on the guitar. And then after that, then I just kind of developed as I was going to school. I got into a band with some of my friends, and I've just been stuck doing it ever since.
Tom inspires me to do music. He does.
Oh, really?
Tom gets in the way of everything. That's what he gets in.
Yes. Tom how does gets he inspire in the way you? Of all sorts of things.
How does he inspire you, Farah?
Well, it's because one reason why he inspires me, sorry if I do get emotional, because I am in that state of mind right now. Tom Billington, you are just amazing, and I'm so glad I found a friend in you. And next week, I'm going to give you the biggest hug and talk to you for a while. I can't wait.
Well, nice. That is exciting, and it is lovely. Thank you so much, Farah. Farah,
you're welcome.
I realize that we haven't asked Tabby to sing nearly enough. So,
I'm happy just chatting and listening to everybody.
We should get him to sing a song. Tabby, like, Farah, like, who is your favorite, apart from obviously Electric Umbrella, who is your favorite singer ever?
Well, my favorite singer has to be Michael Jackson or the Jackson Fives.
Okay, right. So what I would like from you, Tabby, is the whole of the first 4 Michael Jackson albums on an acoustic guitar.
Oh, sure, no problem. Hold on a second. Let me just pick it out of my sock here. There we go.
Hey, thank you so much, Farah. We're going to come to some more questions after this. But Tabby, like, it doesn't matter. We just want to hear you sing again. What do you fancy singing for us?
Oh, gosh. Huh?
That's my favourite one.
Oh, that one. Feeling up.
Nice.
Gotta do a little bit of Johnny Cash. Just all right, ladies.
Let's give him a round of applause. He's gonna sing some Johnny Cash for us. It is Tabby Callaghan.
Well, I hear that train a coming. It's a rolling round the bend. And I ain't seen no sunshine since I don't know when. Well, I'm stuck in Folsom prison. Time keeps dragging on. But those people keep a moving. I don't understand their tone. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't you ever play with guns. Well, I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. Cause people keep a moving, I hate my head and cry. Hey! Coffee and smoking big cigars, but I knew I had it coming. I know I can't be free. Well, that trainer keeps it moving, and that's what tortures me. Alrighty, here we go. Is it? on a little further down the line. Yeah, Bob and Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. Well, I'll let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away. Well, I'll let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
Ladies and gentlemen,
thank you, Wesley.
Round of applause. Woo, woo, woo. Yes, that is what we're talking about, Tabby. You are most welcome here. That is amazing. I'm going to show you just what how amazing you are by just simply showing you Jamie, because that's all anyone needs to see sometimes. Jamie, looking super cool as ever. Jamie, what have you got going on now?
This is the wolf I showed you, and this is the key that as well. And there's this, and there's a She's a beast shooter.
Yeah.
And a sword, and a beast X sword.
Well, look, I mean, obviously, Tabby, you've inspired Jamie to get his superhero.
Jamie is armed to the teeth. Over
yeah,
there.
I mean, you don't want to go out looking like that, Jamie.
Oh, man, he's leading a militia, superhero militia.
You never quite know what's going to happen around here. Very good. Hey, speaking of which, I'm going to introduce you to a friend of ours called Tomo. Tomo is here, and what? It is none other than Tomo's. Tomo, is it your birthday today?
All right.
Yep.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, wow. It is his birthday today. Tomo, what is that?
Made out of Lego.
A Lego.
Whoa, it's a Fender Lego. That is so cool.
That is so cool. It is Tomo's birthday. On our album, Tabby, like we met Tomo just before lockdown, and actually on our album, Tomo here is the big inspiration for one of the songs on our album, which is called The Crab Dance. Okay. And for Tomo's birthday specifically, I figured that we probably got time to do this and maybe a few other bits, but seeing as it's his birthday, we should get him to do the crab dance for us, don't you think?
Sounds great. I'd love to see the crab dance.
What?
Man, I've got old legs.
You've got old legs? What do you mean you've got old legs?
I've been walking all day.
Oh, you've been walking all day. Where have you been walking?
To Portsmouth.
You walked to Portsmouth? From
the car. Oh, on the beach.
Oh, okay. You went to Portsmouth on the beach.
And guess what I found, dude?
What did you find, dude?
I found a real life-size crab. I'm not joking. I'm telling the truth.
You're telling the truth. Listen, Tabby, have you ever had crabs?
I've seen...
Don't answer that question. What we're going to do is we're going to just do a bit of crab dance. This is for young Tomo. If you feel like doing the crab dance with us, Tabby, please feel free. It goes a little something like this. Take it away, Tomo. That's it. Both arms up. Here we go. Here we go.
Do the crab dance, do the crab dance. Pop your cheeks on out and do the crab dance. Do the crab dance, do the crab dance. Pop your cheeks on out and do the crab dance.
Who else is crabbing out there, everybody?
Go side to side and do the crab dance. Do the crab dance, do the crab dance. Go side to side and do the crab dance. Do the crab, a crab, a crab. Do the crab, a crab, a crab. Do the crab, a crab, a crab. Do the crab dance, crab dance.
Yes, everyone, let's get everybody crabbing. Yes, Mike is crabbing. Who else is crabbing? Let's go, Molly! Yeah, Charlie is crabbing. Heidi is crabbing. Ailey is crabbing. Come on, Raph. Show us how it's done. Come on, let's see if Tabby's doing it here. Come on, Tabby. Woo-hoo! All right, ladies and gentlemen, massive round of applause. That's the way we roll here on EUTV, doing a bit of crabbing. Well done, Tomo, and happy birthday. That is for you, Tomo. Bit of happy birthday. Come on, everybody, sing it out.
Happy birthday, dear Tomo the Crab. Happy birthday to you.
All right, let's give him a round of applause. Well done. Love it, Tomo. We will see you at the gig next week. Tabby, did you know that Electric Umbrella have a gig next week? This is our second of our gigs that we're doing. We're doing a residency.
Brilliant. Where is it?
A monthly residency in our hometown of Watford, which is just north of London. And there's a lot of people.
I know Watford.
Yeah, a lot of people around here from just north of London, and we do love it. Gavin is going to be with us on the gig. Gavin, are you excited about the gig next week?
Yeah, I might do this.
You might do some cockatoo dance. Gavin, like, what was so good about the first one? Because we did our first one, Tabby, last month. And it was just so nice to just be back in the same room, Gavin, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was so excited.
Yeah. And what?
Really?
What,
yeah. That sounds great.
What song are you going to sing, Gav?
Next week, I'll be singing. Who are you going to call?
Ghostbusters.
Yes. You got it.
Very
good. Snap, Gavin.
We're looking forward to that. Nice one, Gav. Tabby, there's always so much.
Can I ask a question?
Oh, yeah. Go on then, Gavin. Take it away.
What's your favorite song you ever played on your guitar?
Oh yeah,
gosh, that's a really good question. Do you know what I actually think it is? I think it was Amy that was asking about it earlier. I actually think it might be Sweet Child of Mine. Like, I think that's my, when I play it on the guitar, I think I just, that's the part where I just like, I it makes me really buzz. I love it.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great one to play. Gavin, I think you and I have sung Sweet Child of Mine many a time. You know, it just kind of gets you right where it matters, doesn't it? I think Tabby, I've played Sweet Child of Mine with you when we did Young Voices, didn't we?
Yeah, I think you did. And, you know, I mean, it's just like, do you remember when we were doing Young Voices and then, the kids all sing out, wow, wow.
Yeah.
I mean, you know... You're not going to get an experience like that anywhere. And I don't care who you are. You're never going to have that.
Well, look, you know, as and when, Victoria, I've got a good idea. Why don't we tell Tabby that whenever we're playing over here or even over there, that you are most welcome to come and play with us. Now, that would be a wicked gig, don't you think?
Yeah, it'd be great for having Tabby to come with an Electric Umbrella and play with you guys.
You know what? Stranger things have happened. I might drop over.
I think you absolutely must. Victoria, let's get you to ask a question because time is rushing on. We're going to get through a bunch of questions now. So what would you like to ask?
I'd like to ask, have you ever done any collaborations with any groups?
Oh, great idea.
Oh, gosh, yeah.
Like the my favourite is The Script, for instance.
Oh, you like The Script?
I like The Script, yeah. I want to see them. I've never been to a live gig, so I'm hoping one day, fingers crossed, I'll get to see them.
Oh, really, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I like The Script as well, actually. And
and Maroon 5. I like Maroon 5 as well.
Do you? Maroon 5 too? Yeah. I see The Script have a new album or something out. I was looking at their...
Yeah, it's Tales of The Script or something.
Yeah, something like that.
Tales from the Trilogy or something.
Something like that, yeah. Have you heard any of it?
No, not yet, no.
Yeah,
I'm always listening to music. I have Spotify and I add it to my list, so...
Yeah. I think, I've got to do, like, loads of collaborations over the years, like, not just with kind of, you know, people, like, you know, who would be, like, known or whatever. I mean, I've done, like, with, I just did one there last year. We have a thing here in my town in Sligo, and there's a guy here called Kieran Quinn, and he does these kind of big musical nights where there could be, like, 100 people on the stage at the end of the night.
A lot of people, yeah.
A lot, and they're not all musicians, by the way. A lot of them are just like ordinary dudes who get together for these particular concerts, and they go in then and they might sing these songs and they blow people away because nobody knows that these people can sing like this.
Yeah.
You know? And this is kind of, for me, that's really exciting for me, to be honest. Yeah. Like, I love that kind of thing. Because
that's basically what Electric Umbrella is. That's what Electric Umbrella is like.
Yeah.
You know, it's what we are interested in, and I'm sure you believe in this, and my friend Ty is here, and he's going to back me up on this. This is all about, you know, like asking people to think differently about stuff, you know, like when you think you've got someone sus just by what they look like, but they get up and they blow you away with a performance. There's nothing better than that.
There is nothing in the world that like will blow your mind more than like, you know, you meet a person or whatever, and you might have a perception in your mind. We all do it. And then suddenly this just person comes out and just blows your mind.
Yeah.
That there is like, you know,
that's a good link into this fella that's just joined us here. This is Ty, everybody. Let's give Ty a round of applause.
Hi, Ty. Ty, is that right, Ty?
Yes.
Now,
nice to meet you, Ty.
Turn yourself up a little bit, Ty. Ty is from Northern Ireland there. So we
know.
Yeah, I've got a few of you over there today. How are you doing, Ty?
I'm fine. How are you all?
We're doing all right. Ty is a great singer, Tabby, and has come to Electric Umbrella via Zoom and via all of this stuff. He actually is the lead vocal on the opening track of our album. So when I send it to you, you'll have a good listen.
I will, certainly.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Nice to meet you, Ty.
Ty, you got a question?
Nice to meet you too.
Yeah, absolutely.
You got a question you'd like to ask, mate?
Let's have a think. What is, now, here, your favourite song, right? But here's my question. What is the hardest song you have ever played?
Oof. Tricky.
Oh, gosh, that's a good question. Gosh, I'd be stumped now.
Well, sometimes things are really high, and that can be a thing. You know, like sometimes, every time I sing, like, you know, Bon Jovi, Living on a Prayer or something, you get to that last bit, you're like, oh, right, this is hard, you know?
Do you know what I actually did recently? It's funny you say that. I would say vocally, right, vocally, the one song that I found really tough that I've had to do is George Michael, Wham, Freedom.
Right.
Like, I don't want your freedom. That is so high.
Yeah.
Right? Like, I couldn't even find a video of George Michael doing it himself live, you know? And once I couldn't find a video of him, I thought, sugar, what am I going to do here? Like, so I had to, I couldn't even drop the key as well because it doesn't sound right, Tom. Do you know what I mean? Oh, like, when you, there's just something about the tone of, like, when, you know. Yeah. So I found, yeah, probably George Michael. And I also had to do one time, I had to do Live and Let Die by Paul McCartney. And that was a really tough one as well because
it did matter to you.
Yeah.
So good, isn't it?
Yeah, I hope that answers your question, Ty. What about yourself?
Yeah, I was going to say, Ty, what's the hardest one you've had to do?
The hardest song I have ever done would probably have been Empty Chairs and Empty Tables from Les Mis.
Well.
Okay, Les Mis, or okay.
There's a grief that can't be broken. It's just so good, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's so good. Hey, we've got to crack on because it's like literally, Tabby, I know I could introduce you to every single person that we've got here. I'm going to say get one more little question in who have we got here? We've got Tubbo is here. Hey, Tubbo. Just real quick, because obviously we've got England, Wales. We haven't got to anyone in Scotland yet, but Tubbo's going to ask a very quick question. And then, Tabby, if you don't mind, we're going to see us out on a song. You grab something. Tubbo, quickly, what are you going to ask?
What's your favourite colour?
What's your favourite colour? I mean, these are the big questions. Obviously,
colour.
Yellow and black, obviously.
Do you know, that's a really good question. What's my favourite colour? I actually think my favourite colour is, like amber.
I'm aware of amber.
You know, but not in a kind of, like, if I seen amber on a wall, I probably wouldn't like it. But when I see, like, amber, as in, like, a piece of amber.
Yeah.
Or when I see, like, an evening sunset, you know, when the sun is setting, is that amber colour. That's probably my favourite colour.
Well, there you go. That is
and outside of that would be purple.
That is a good thing. Thank you, Tubbo. Hey, Emily, why are people not hurrying me up? Because I'm always running out of time.
Don't know.
This is what happens, Emily. We had all sorts of plans, but they all go out the window. Emily, please join me in saying thank you so much to Tabby.
Thank you, Tabby.
You, anything you'd like to say before we go, Emily?
I'd like to say that you've got a really good voice. I really like the singing voice.
Oh, thanks a lot, Emily. For what's left of it now, because I'm a bit hoarse after all my gigs at the weekend, but thanks anyway.
That's all good. And Damon.
And Mackerson.
Yeah.
Sorry, say that again, Emily. What were you going to say?
Do you know any Mackerson signing?
Signing, yes.
Yeah.
By who?
Have you?
No. Any signings?
Sorry, I'll ask again. Do you know any sign language? Have you ever learned?
Do I know any sign language?
Yeah, because Emily is an expert.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Well, show me how to say. Show me how to say. Hi. Hi. Hello. How are you? We'll start with that.
Right.
Hi.
Yeah.
Right.
And how are you? So your thumbs, yeah.
So you go, hi.
Hi, how are you?
How are you?
So this is something it's called Mackerton, and it's like supported speech. It's not the same as British Sign Language.
Yeah, but I really like that though. So
really beautiful.
So I go like this, hi.
Yeah, hi.
How
are you?
How are you? So do I point the thumbs out towards the other person?
Yeah, so thumbs out, so how are you?
All right, so then if I'm the other person and I want to say, hi, do I say, I'm great, or how does that work? I feel good.
You just go, I'm great, good.
Point your thumb and thumb up.
Yeah.
But right, also,
I want to ask one more, Tom.
Yeah, go for it.
How would you ask, what's your favorite food? How would you say that?
What?
Okay.
What?
Your
favorite
food.
So one more time. What?
What's your
favorite
food?
Oh, that's brilliant. What's that called? That's called what?
It's called
Mackerton.
Mackerton.
So is it like kind of like slang, shorthand? It's kind of like shorter.
Yeah. So it's used.
It's kind of used mainly. For, like, people who are non-verbal.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah,
because sometimes you see them at this crack, like, and then you'd be like, gosh, I couldn't keep up with that. But, you know, I'd be like, oh. Be like, listen.
But we do use it on electric umbrella as well. I help out a lot with it. So
you do. And so we can say, so you say thank you, which is that.
Thank you.
And you can say for coming on. An electric is, you do like a lightning bolt. Electric.
All right.
Umbrella.
Oh, really?
Yeah, electric umbrella. So you just
say, oh, that's brilliant. Electric.
You'd say, thank you for coming on electric umbrella.
Okay, hold on a second. How do I say my pleasure or you're welcome? How do I say that?
Double,
the old thumbs up.
Double thumbs up, mate. It goes a long, long way. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give them a huge round of applause. I'm really sorry if we haven't got to your questions. Keely, I really wanted to come to you, but I think I've run out of time. We are going to get another song because we're already out of time. If you wouldn't mind playing us out, Tabby, it really has been a joy to have you on. Have you got anything you'd like to say before we sign out?
I suppose I'd just like to say that it was a real pleasure getting to meet everyone here. Getting to see what the electric umbrella is all about. I love the concept, Tom. I love what you're doing with the album. I love the fact you're doing gigs. It's great to meet everybody on here, and I can see everybody is like well involved and right into it. So that was a real pleasure, and it was great. And hopefully, you know what, maybe I'll come back on again sometime, and maybe we'll do a song together.
We'd love that. We would really love that. So yeah, everybody that is saying yes and thank you. What are you going to sing for us last to see us out, mate?
I could probably give maybe Amy Ask for Sweet Child of Mine.
All right. So let's give him a round of applause, everybody. It is Sweet Child of Mine, Tabby Callaghan style, here on Electric Umbrella TV. Thank you so much to everybody. We'll be saying goodnight after this. We really love you all. And take it away, Tabby.
Got a smile that it seems to me remind me of childhood memory, when everything was as precious as a bright blue sky.
Now and then when I see her face, she takes me away to that special place. If you stay too long, Robbie break down and cry.
Sing it with me.
Umbrella TV for our 143rd show. Tabby, thank you so much. Everyone is saying a huge thank you. It's really been a pleasure to have you around, mate. Really, really loved it. Thank you.
Tom, pleasure's been all mine, mate. And it's been great to meet everybody. And you know what? This has actually kind of cheered me up a little bit myself and my own
life. That's so. All we need sometimes. You just need a bit of togetherness, a bit of joy, a bit of music, and we go a long, long way, doesn't it?
Hey, there's power in numbers, right?
There's power in numbers. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for us to go. Thank you so much. We're really sorry if we didn't get to your question. I'm sure Tabby is reachable on Facebook because that is the place where we all go. And we can find all about Tabby's music there on Facebook. Very easy to find. Lots of love to you all. It really is time to go. I suppose just a few things that I must say. We have launched a campaign today to get 1,000 instruments donated to Electric Umbrella before Christmas. That is 1,000 instruments. We are going to use them on our tours at our gigs. We are going to donate them to our friends who need them. We are going to sell them to make money for the charity, and we are going to turn them into clocks and lamps and things if they don't work. So 1,000 instruments. Think about what you or what your friends or what your schools might have locked away and send them to us. It's very easy to do so. You go to electricumbrella.co.uk/1,000. Tabby, we're going to have 1,000 instruments to play.
Sounds great, man.
Going to be good. We will see you all later. If you want to come to our gig next Tuesday, it's in Watford. It'll be great to see you. Chris, the drummer, I hope you're coming. You absolutely nailed it last time. Dylan, we're going to see you there. Everybody else, I cannot wait to see you. Let's give you all a massive wave. And thank you to Tabby. Thank you to Gavin. Thank you to Billy. Thank you to everybody who makes this thing work. We will see you all very soon. Thank you to Caroline and Debbie and Amy, of course, everyone over there on Facebook. This will go out on YouTube in a few days, and we hope you enjoy it there. And we're just going to sing the chorus one more time. Because that always goes a long way. Thank you very much, everybody. Give us a wave. We're going to close this thing down in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bye, everyone. See you later.